chords. So just a refresher on the chords. Learn these chords. So this is C, G, E, B flat, D. Just memorize this. This is what you're gonna play when you're doing every two for now. We start there and then I'll show you some other cool rhythms. Okay? So this chord, this is incidentally, if you're wondering, C major, the flat seven. This is called a C7.
Right.
With a D, this is called a 9. This is called a C dominant 9 chord. So I'm taking the C and the G and I'm putting them here.
Okay.
So we have split up the chord. Do the same thing with F9. We got F, A, C, E flat, G. I'm taking the power chord, putting it down here. And the last one is G9. G, B, D, F, A. Taking the power chord. So you play those just along with the accompaniment.
Okay.
Okay. And again, be able to play just the accompaniment along with the recording, just the chords along with the recording, with the right hand, and then the left hand. And be crazy. You could do it with both hands. And then the melody by itself, and then the melody octaves.
Okay.
You can even do this. So the point is you want to be able to mix and match. When you can do each one, when you're really, really good at each one individually, bass, chords, melody, then you can try to put them together, bass and chords, like this, bass and melody, right? Chords and melody. You know? And also play around with the C minor blues scale. So you have C, E flat, F, F sharp, G, B flat.
Okay.
Play around with that. So without the left hand, with just the recording, you can just kind of... As long as you have good rhythm, stay in that scale, it's gonna not sound terrible.
C minor blues scale.